All right, let's go.
Booker T. He's not even going to make it to New York last night tonight.
A lot going on in the backstage area, but let's take them one at a time. Jeff Jarrett coming in with a guitar saying Booker T's name. He doesn't realize Booker T's not here tonight.
I wonder what his reaction's going to be when he finds out that Booker T's not here.
Tony, it's already been ascertained that my brother's not here. But I want to know something. Does Crowbar have a thing for death?
He seems to be speechless when he's around the girl.
Smitten, it looked like. Seemed like he had some feelings for her, didn't it?
Hey, suckers need to know, you know what I'm saying? But
they need to know.
Prime time.
Here he comes. Prime time, Elix Skipper. I want to tell you, of all the young men who have come through.
Hey,
wait a minute.
This is my house. So I want everybody to have a seat. Put your seatbelts on. I'm going to show y'all something y'all ain't never seen before. Actually, what I'm going to do is give you a taste of prime time.
Got a little attitude as well, but he's one of the most sensational young men we've seen in a long time, Mike, today.
He's got that attitude. He's got a new name, Primetime Elix Skipper, and he's certainly been impressive here in World Championship Wrestling.
I think that's what happens when you hang around a guy like I am, Smooth, and asking him for... Yeah. I have no idea what it was that he got, but it seems like he got his attitude right now.
Am I smooth?
Or whatever.
For a name and for a new outlook. Look at this. Crowbar sends him over the ropes.
Man.
All the way to the floor. You hear Daphne in the background with that shirt she made for Crowbar. And what about the Memphis flag match that the commissioner has booked for tonight between Lance Storm and Mike Awesome?
You telling me it's going to be a flag? A Canadian flag on one side, an American flag on the other side. That's the way it goes, Tony.
That's all. Look at this.
Oh, man.
My goodness. What a move that was.
Prime Time has ran into a guy that has more offensive maneuvers than anybody I know. He's a very offensive-minded person, this Crowbar. But I want to see, this is a classic matchup, Tony.
Let's see what Crowbar can do now to follow that up. Nicely done. Outside in, but he hurt himself. Crowbar wrestles with reckless abandon.
Yes, he does. I mean,
not afraid to hurt himself is what you're saying with a high-risk move like he just did right there.
No, he does not.
It seems like, Mike, that it pumps him up. The more he gets hurt, the more focused Crowbar becomes.
Was that M.I. Smooth and with flowers?
Who else could it be coming out with that smile?
M.I. A bouquet.
Now, what is this crime?
A bouquet of flowers. He whispered something to Daphne.
That's Smooth.
What's from M.I. Smooth?
I don't know who they're from. Who are they from?
And Daphne has got everybody going crazy. This guy got a thing for her, too, right?
Did I read her lips? Did she just say secret admirer?
I believe that's what she's a secret admirer for Daphne.
Did you see that move by Prime Time?
Spectacular. Prime Time tries to follow it up with something, but Crowbar's got him in his clutches. Prime Time trying to work his way around, and he did. Forward roll. What a great pinning combination. One, two, no.
Yes, yes.
Almost got it. I want to tell you, even though he didn't win it with that, that was sensational. Great balance by Prime Time. Elix Skipper up top. And look at him chop away. Once again, the pain seems to push Crowbar to the limit.
Yeah, that combined with the screeches and screams from ringside of Daphne.
That's about to deafen my ears.
Up on top. Caught. Prime Time.
Oh, yes.
Fireman's carry dropped that time from. Oh, she's ecstatic.
Is she ecstatic?
Wait a minute. Wait, hold on now. He's left the match.
Why would he do that?
Did he give her these flowers?
What's going on in this guy's head? Prime Time. He's not Prime Time in the ring to go out and talk about some.
Apparently not. He's wondering where the
flowers are. Oh, man.
Did you see that spinning, twisting, over the top maneuver that time? By Elix Skipper Prime Time.
Yeah, because of the distraction. Crowbar communicating.
Oh, man. Right
communicating
in the face.
With Daphne.
Look out.
From the look on Crowbar's face, I'm not sure that he was the one that sent those flowers. He was asking questions.
She whacked him with the bouquet of flowers.
You know, Am I Smooth picked those flowers in the back of the building somewhere, snuck them out there. You know, there's too many rats running around here in WCW.
Rats?
Yeah, that's what I said, rats.
I don't know. I think Smooth told her those were from a secret admirer from someone else. You don't buy that, I can tell, Stevie Ray, but...
Hey, brother, I don't put anything past that guy.
I understand that. And Elix Skipper, he's up on top. Prime Time, Elix is in trouble now. Crowbar looking out to this great crowd on hand. You see Daphne?
Man, he fell right on his head, Tony.
Trying to Frankenstein him from the top, and Prime Time caught him, so he's up on top. What's he going to do?
Oh.
Sunset Flip going to try and take him over. Crowbar blocks it.
He missed it. Did Primetime. And Crowbar trying to pull him up now by his neck.
Elix. That's his finishing move. What? That is it.
One, two, three. That's the move that he calls the overdrive. And Primetime Elix Skipper pulls out a win on Thunder.
Primetime Elix Skipper is for real. But who gave Daphne the bouquet of flowers? We'll be back.
Hey, Jimmy Hart, what the hell are they talking about? Booker T's not here tonight. You mean the champ's not on Thunder?
Booker T's not here
for
tonight.
For what reason?
Well, he's got a taped interview a little later
on. Oh,
the
another
show.
One of those dumbass shoot interviews. Is that the reason?
It's only four more days to New Blood Rising. Can't you wait?
No, I don't think I can. That Booker T better show up tonight.
Well, you're going to have to wait.
I don't.